Hi everyone, it's Jen and welcome back to Hashtag Friday Reads. So it's been a slow reading week, I have to admit. I only read one book this week and it was not something that I had on my list, but it was something that I picked up randomly at the library. I have a bit of a fibromyalgia flare going on, and sometimes when that happens, you get this thing called fibro fog, which really sucks because it's really like having your head in a fog. You can't take in things, you don't remember things, you have a hard time talking. I mean, it's different for everyone, but that's what it is for me. And you comprehend slower. You might hear Emilio screaming. I apologize. So you comprehend slower and it's just difficult, but I have to say that since I've started reading regularly and I'm doing it every single day, I've noticed that I'm not experiencing that lull where I have to like step away from books and I can't concentrate and I can't read. It's just slower. So it's a good thing. It's improving and I'm very encouraged by that. But anyway, the book that I read this week was this one, Oxygen. This was really good. This was a medical drama. That's what I would say, medical drama. It's a story of an anesthesiologist who loses a patient, and the patient is a child. And basically, even though, you know, it can happen, obviously, it haunts her. This one particular case haunts her, and it's her journey through this situation. And it was so good. I didn't expect it to be as good or for me to like it as much as I did, but I really enjoyed this, and my pain management doctor is an anesthesiologist, and I actually talked with him yesterday about this book, and he's going to read it now, so passing on the love of learning and reading, that's a good thing. But I had no idea what goes into anesthesiology, and this gives you a really good idea. I think you'll be surprised at how much they actually have to be prepared and what they have to do in order to have a surgery procedure. So really good. I highly recommend this one, and I will definitely be reading more by this author. And then two other things I picked up from the library, just briefly. This one is Girls on Fire, and this is by Robin Wasserman. I haven't read anything by her before. This one says, by turns, a shocking story of love and violence and an addictive portrait of the intoxication of female friendship. Girls on Fire is an incendiary and unforgettable snapshot of girlhood. Girls lost and girls found, girls weak and strong, girls who burn bright and brighter, and girls who flicker away. So it sounds interesting. Like I said, I've heard mixed reviews, so don't know if I'm going to like it, but I figured I saw it at the library, I'll take it out. If I don't like it, back it goes, and I didn't put any money out for it. And that's basically the same thing with this one. I just like randomly found this one. It was one I've been interested in, but wasn't sure I really wanted to buy. This is The Thousandth Floor by Catherine McGee. I don't really know if I'm going to like this one, to be honest with you. It sounds kind of odd. It's about this building that has 1,000 floors in New York City. And I believe there's some sort of like cities or something like that on every floor. I don't know. The review that I saw of it seemed like it was positive, but ultimately, I don't think the person really liked it all that much, to be honest with you, because it was one of those reviews that seemed very, like it was lacking information that I really should have had. So that's why I just decided I'm just going to take it from the library, and if I don't like it, I didn't invest anything, so it can go back. And then, I did make a trip to Barnes & Noble this weekend. This weekend? No. This week? Yesterday? My doctor is near Barnes & Noble, so went there, so yeah. I don't know, this is going to be a weird video this week, guys, sorry. And I was lucky I found this one. This is Gemini, and this is by Carolyn Casella, the one who wrote Oxygen, and I found it on clearance, so I'm so excited. This is another medical drama, and to be honest with you, I didn't really read too much of the synopsis because now I really like her writing, and I just know I want to read all the books she has. I think she only has three or four, but I was lucky to find this one, so I picked this one up. I don't know when I'm going to read it. I never know, because I never know what I'm going to pick up, but like I said, I really like her writing, so I'm happy to have that. And then I picked up this one. I really wanted this one. I read one of his books. This is Nutshell by Ian McEwan. I read one of his books, Atonement, years ago, and I really liked it. This is a really short one, and this is a weird story. It's the story of, like, a man and a woman, and I don't know if they're both married or just one of them is married, but this man and woman meet, and they decide to kill one of the spouses. And I believe, it's the story told from the child that the woman is pregnant with. So the child knows everything that's going on. And that just sounds weirdly good. So since I've read him before, I just had to pick it up. So I got that one. And I'd like to read that one soon because it just came out and I don't want to have any spoilers and it's really short. So I hope I could get to that one. Another one that I am going to pick up this weekend, it's going to be my next read that I'm actually going to start today, is this one. It's The Wonder by Emma Donahue. I've spoken about this one before. It comes out on Tuesday. It's the story of a girl who seems to be surviving only without like food or water, and people don't know if it's a miracle or if it's a farce or what the heck is going on. So it's only a little over 200 pages or something like that on ebook. So I'm looking forward to reading it. This is a review book and I want to get it read so we can talk about it on Monday. And that is all that I have for you guys this week. I do have some review books that I got and I'm going to wait to show you guys those on Monday. Also, I'm going back to Barnes & Noble because I had a book in my hands and I really wanted it and I put it back and Frank was like, why did you do that? And I said, I don't know. So he's going to take me to Barnes & Noble, I think, tomorrow, and I'm going to pick up that book, and he usually lets me get whatever I want, so we'll see if there's anything else I want, and then I'll show you guys Monday. So that's that. I wanted to talk to you guys about this one. I'm still doing the read-along for this one, and it's coming up. We're going to start September 30th. So I'm having a little trouble with trying to figure out how many pages we should read. What you guys think would be fair, because I was going to say we could read up to chapter 5, but there's no chapter numbers in this book. They're only names. So it's going to be hard because although this one says That Morning, 1970 Charlotte, most of them just start with a name at the top like this. So we're going to have to read up to a page number. So I'd like to know what you guys think is fair or that you could handle reading in a day so that we could maybe do an update like every 2 or 3 days. What do you guys think would work for you? Leave it in the comments down below. And also, if you're interested in filming the video to do one of the updates for this, please leave it down below so I can start writing down the names. And I'm going to try to gather your opinions and what I think we could do and how long it's going to take us to read this. Let me see, how many pages is this book? It's about 350, maybe a little bit more than that, like 358 or something like that. So I want to be fair to you guys. I want it to be fun for everyone, not be stressful. So just leave me a message in the comments below and let me know what you think is fair for everyone to read as far as page numbers a day. And also, how often would you like to get together to talk about it? So I would like to get all these opinions before I can make a decision on that sort of thing. And I think that's it. That is all that I have on my list for the weekend. I don't know what else I'm going to pick up besides The Wonder. It depends on my reading, like how fast I can go and stuff, so I don't want to set out too much stuff. If I can get to that book, The Nutshell, I probably will pick that one up this weekend. But you can follow along with us on Instagram. The link is below. It's at Reading with Pugs. Also, I'm on Goodreads. The link is below. And I will be snapping on Sunday. So I don't have a lot of plans other than getting my nails done on Sunday. So I probably will be able to do some good snaps and talk about some reading and stuff like that. So all the information is down below. All these books will be linked down below. And I think that's it. So guys, have a wonderful reading weekend. I'd love to know what you're reading. Thank you for joining today. And as always, happy reading.